In today's video, we are going to discuss upon the what is an organizational unit and what is the group policy and how we can apply the group policy on the organizational unit. So for the organizational unit, in the short form, we can call it as the OU. And if you have not gone through the previous videos, I have placed the links in description. You can just go through them. So when it comes to the organizational unit, the organization unit is a container within the Microsoft Windows Active Directory. And in the OU, we can place users, groups, computers, and other OUs also. So now let me take you to the Active Directory and let me show you how the OU will be. So I'm opening the Active Directory users and computers. So here, if I expand my domain, I can see all the containers. So these all are called as the containers. But here, only two has the file symbol inside the containers. So that is called as the OU. So if you see here, for the domain controllers, we have a file symbol inside it. So this is an OU. Even for the India also, we have a file symbol inside it. So even this is an OU. So this is how you can separate the containers and the OUs. For all the OUs, you will be having a symbol like this inside the container. So as I said earlier, in the OU, we can place users, groups, computers, and other OUs. So let me expand this OU India. If I expand this OU India, under this India OU, I can see the computers, I can see the users, and also I can see the groups and other organizational units. So if an organization contains several domains, they can create organizational unit structures in each and every domain. In each and every domain, they can create the OU structures, and we can link the group policies to all the objects in the OU. We can link the group policies to all the objects in the OU. Objects means the computers, groups, and the users. So this is what the advantage of OU. So you can apply the group policy for the entire OU. And now let me create a new OU. So here we have the India OU, right? Under my domain. So let me create a new OU. For creating the new OU, I'm right clicking on my domain, then new, and selecting the organizational unit. So here I'm placing as Americas. And at the bottom, if you see, protect container from accidental deletion. So if you select this, and if by mistake, if you click on delete, then it will not be getting deleted. You will be getting a pop-up that do not have the required permissions. So it's always better whenever you are creating your OU, you need to checkbox this. Let me click on OK. So here, organizational unit has been created. So how we can say that this is an OU? Because we have the symbol inside the container. Okay. So now under this Americas OU, let me create the new OU. So let me create the OU for users, and let me create one more OU for computers. So we can differentiate in this way. So for example, if I have employees from India, then I can place their accounts under the India OU in users. And if I have employees from the Americas region, then under the Americas OU, we can add these users and also the computers. And you can apply the different group policies based upon the organization requirements to the particular OU. So now let's discuss upon the what is a group policy object. What is a group policy object? So the group policy object means It's a collection of group policy settings. Collection of group policy settings is called as a group policy object. Collection of group policy settings is called as the group policy object. So with the help of group policy object, we can define what permissions the users can have on the system. By applying the group policies, we can define like what permissions the users can have on the system. Because in every organization, all the users are not going to get the same access level. So based upon their work, the access level will be determined. And the access levels are determined by the group policy object in the Active Directory. So this is the important point, because the access levels are determined by the group policy object in the Active Directory. And we can apply group policy on domain as well as the on the OU. So if you want to apply any group policy, you can directly apply it on the complete domain. Okay, if you want to apply any group policy, you can apply it on the complete domain. So if you apply it on the complete domain, then it will be applicable for all these containers and OUs. Or if not, if you want to apply it for only any particular OU, you can apply it. So now let me show you how we can apply the group policy on particular OU. So for that, we need to go to the server manager, then click on tools, and now we need to click on the group policy object. So here I can see my forest. So let me minimize this all. So here I can see my forest pyt-courses.onmicrosoft.com. If I expand my forest, I can see domain sites, the group policy modeling, and the group policy results. So if I expand my domains, then I can see my domain pyt-courses.onmicrosoft.com. Let me even expand this. So here I can see all the OUs. So we have created the Americas OU right now, the domain controller India, the group policy objects, and the starter GPOs. So now I want to create a group policy for the users under Americas region. Okay, for the under Americas OU. So let me right click on this. And now we need to click on create a GPO in this domain and link it here. So always you need to select this, create a GPO in this domain and link it here. So I want to create a group policy as that if any users from the Americas OU, from the Americas organizational unit, if any user want to open the control panel, it should not be open. Means the access should not be provided for the control panel on their system. So let me create it as turn underscore off underscore control panel. Let me click on OK. So now if I expand this, see here I can see the turn off control panel. So now let me click on this and then edit. So now I need to go into the user configuration, and under user configuration we need to go to the policies, and under policies, as I said, that I want to apply the group policy on control panel settings. So I need to click on the administrative templates. Then here I can see the control panel. So let me click on control panel, and here I can see all the settings or all the group policies that can be applied on the control panel. So as I said earlier, I want the users should not get access for the control panel. So if any of the user from the Americas OU, if they want to access the control panel, the access should be denied. So here I can see an option called as prohibit access to control panel and PC settings. Let me double click on this, and now it's showing as not configured. Let me click on enabled. Okay, so now I enable the control panel settings. Let me click on apply, and then okay. So now if any user, from the Americas OU, if any user from the Americas OU, if they go onto the system and if they search for the control panel, they would not be able to access it. They would be getting an error message like, you do not have the required permissions to access the control panel, or if not, the access has been blocked by your system administrator. Kindly contact the admin. So this is what meant by a group policy object, and this is how you will be applying the group policies on the OU. Thank you for watching this video, and if you feel that this video is helpful for you, please do like this, and also don't forget to subscribe our channel POIT.